Hey guys, it's Just Cards by Sara. Today I want to share my design team project for Crafty Ann. I made this card. Basically, I've used a lot of mixed media techniques in the background. And I started off with just a white piece of watercolour paper. And I sprayed these colours. I sprayed this colour, and oops, I forgot one of the colours. Can't do that. Okay, Shabby Turpentine Teal. So I used that from the Industrial Chic collection. Actually, these are all from the Industrial Chic collection, yep. Rusty Lantern Lime and Steampunk Sepia. So I used those three colours. And I sprayed the back. And then I just started layering my stamps, and I used my stencils. These are the inks I used. So I've used the Teal Blue and the Vintage Photo. The masks I used was this one here. I also used some of the splodges and the coffee ring. I also used the crackles, which you can see up the top. I also used the leaves. And I also bleached it because I kind of put it on and you can kind of see it in spots down here. Okay. So there is that one. I love that one. That was my favorite. Okay. And then what I did was I just then started layering, and it's absolutely gorgeous underneath. I was so devastated that I covered it, but it just, the layers just came together so easily and it just looked so good. So I just went with it. Okay, so basically what I've done is I've layered the dyes I've used. Actually, I'll start with that. The Flourish 3, so that's gorgeous. As you can see, I'm ready for my next projects. I used Border 8, which is absolutely gorgeous. These were all from last month's design team package. I used Ornament 2, which is this one here, and the borders inside. And the Flourish 3 is this one here. So, is these ones. And I used Nesting Doll Circles, which is this one here. Oops. I've gone blurry again. Don't you hate that? I don't know why it keeps going out of focus. But, it's not getting any better, is it? Okay, we're back. This one here. Okay, and over the top, as you can see, I've layered like a, I don't know what this is actually called, but it's gold, and it's I love this stuff, and I got given it from my mum's best friend when I first started crafting. It was in that shoebox that's now gone from a shoebox to a craft room that was brought into the hospital, and it was in there, and I absolutely love it, and I don't know what it is, so if anyone knows, please let me know. It kind of feels like dryer sheet, if you know what I'm talking about, but it's gold. Okay, and it comes gold. All right, so then what I used was Butterfly 2. I used the candle set, which you get the two candles and the bow. I actually used this bow here. And the great thing about the bow, it actually has an indent in it. Hang on, I'll pop it. I'll use the one I actually used on the project. And can you see there's like indents on it? And what I've done is I've basically just made it dimensional, so now it's not flat. It's got dimension to it, and you just put your nail in and just pop it up. So then you've got a cute little bow that's dimensional. Okay, so that was that one. So that was the candle set. I've used the feather set. Again, all the feathers are in the way. I love this one. So the bow was here. On the, bring it up here. And the, here's the feathers. So you get the four different feathers. And I've used them here and here. They kind of look like a leaf there though. So it kind of goes well. I've used tag set two, which is, I love these ones because if you're a card maker or whatever, it really comes in handy because it comes with four different things that you can use. So you've got your corners, you've got your two different die cuts, and you've got your border. So it really does come in handy. And I've also used the flower set. So that was that one, that tag set is this one here. So I'll just, hopefully you guys can see that. So it's this one here, the brown. And the flower. So that's flower set. And it cuts out really nice. And you can make really nice flowers with it, actually. There's a flower I made. That's cute. And that's the one right there. And it looks like metal. So it's this one here. Okay, so I'll start. I just dressed all the edges. I started layering, so I've layered my layers on top of each other. All the layers are sprayed with these colours. Okay. And then what I started to do was, this is sprayed, the brown stuff is sprayed, not sprayed, it's actually got one of those tops. I don't know which top it is. I know there's two different ones. It's dark chocolate truffle from Lindy Stamp Gangs, the Starburst. So it's brown with a gold base. And I also used Calypso Teal on this flower here. Okay, so basically all the layers were sprayed. And then I went over with my Inca Gold, which you guys know I love to do that. I love that colour, and I was lucky enough for a friend to purchase this for me in the big size, which came really in handy because I had a little one that was really hard to use. Okay, so layered, we've put the butterfly in the middle, which again I've rubbed with Inca Gold. Hopefully you can see that shine popping off. We've got the bow, which I went over. It was yellow and then went over with Distress Ink, a vintage photo. We've got the metal flower and the flower. I've then clustered my flowers here, which I've sprayed with those sprays. This with the rusty lime, this one with that teal, and this one with the steampunk sepia. Then what I've also done is I've layered two flowers here. So we've got a green and a brown. I've also put thread behind, but I don't think you guys are really going to pick up on that. It's here and here. It's like an underneath layer, and it's popping out here. And then what I did was I've layered a feather here and here, which kind of looks like a leaf, so I kind of liked that. And then I've also layered the flourish here and here, and then I've also got the metal piece here and here, which I've cut in half and to make it longer. So that was that. And up the top I've used a corner piece that I've cut just the end off and stuck it up there, as you guys can see. And then I've put one of these little metal flowers on top, which is the same as this one but a different size. And then inside I've just basically kept it simple. I've used sunrise sunset paper and I've lined it with the border edge, and then I've put my die cut noodle so that people can write, and then I'll put my logo on the back. So this is my project. The colours actually came out gorgeous and I really love them. But this is my design team project for Crafty Ann. Sorry, the video was a little bit long. It was a bit hard to explain all the different dyes and stuff. be sure to go check out Crafty Ann, and be sure to go check out, I actually have a Facebook page, which is just Cards by Sara, and where I put all my videos when I upload them. I put photos, I'll put start to finish photos, and stuff like that, everything to do with my work. If I'm going to be doing demos, like I'm doing demos at the Penrith show, I would put that up, and stuff like that. So be sure to go check that out, please. The links are below. And be sure to like and subscribe to the video if you would like to. And let me know what you think. Alright, talk to you later. Oh, and check out Crafty Ann. The links are below.